What's up, guys? It's Coop Dizzle here, and welcome back to another episode here on the Diamond Society SMP. It is another beautiful day here in Red Star, and we're hanging out in the Red Star slums, and we have a couple of really cool projects planned for you today. We are going to do some more landscaping, a little bit like at last episode, I guess. We're going to do some more landscaping here around the slums, just beautifying the place. And then we've got to seriously do a little bit of detail work and put a foundation around the Chrysler Building and call the exterior of that really, really done. But last episode, speaking of which, was a really big episode. And thank you guys so much for all of your support on the video, for all the likes and comments and shares and things like that. So have some diamonds on me, guys. You deserve it. Thank you so much, Coop Dizzle fan. You guys are totally awesome. And thank you so much. And if you do enjoy this episode, please make sure and leave a like on this video as well. And so before we get into projects for this episode, I actually did a lot of work in between episodes, and I want to show you guys some of that as well. So stick around and let's go check some of that stuff out. So here we are at the entrance to the Red Star slums. We're going to walk over the bridge, and on the left here you can see what we did in the last episode. We basically came through and replaced all of the sand and the clay with dirt and planted a whole bunch of trees. I didn't chop down any of these trees. It's a little too dense for my liking, but it does a better job of blocking out the ugliness of the desert. We might come through at some point. I'm not gonna say for sure, but I might wanna go through there and do the same thing over here just to kind of block out some of that as well. I think that would be a cool effect. But I wanted to show you guys what I worked on in between episodes. I just wasn't able to record and I didn't have much else to do, so I came on here and I did the same thing over by Lurgan's house. So this is Lurgan's spot right here. This all used to be mesa, just clay and stuff. So I came through and added in a whole bunch of grass. I did some bone milling, planted some spruce trees, added a few flowers and what are these things called? Ferns here and there. Added a little bit of a pathway here. Not too many different block types, just the path blocks, the coarse dirt, and a few bushes here and there. Let's see, added a couple of rock piles, did these birch leaves here and there, just basic landscaping, but it really made this area much more beautiful, I think. So I think that's pretty good. Oh yeah, I did also a waterfall over here. A little bit hard to see with the shaders, I think, but it's pretty, especially without the shaders. And a little pond over here as well, which my Frostwalker boots don't seem to like, so we're not going to walk on it. So just a little bit of landscaping, just to beautify the place. And what I'm thinking we can do is eventually, now I'm not going to take the time to do a whole bunch of this right now, but eventually I think we can come through here and sort of add a whole bunch of grass, sort of just like, stretching out into the desert, sort of like this maybe. And if we do that from all the sides, I don't know, this is going to be kind of a long-term project, But if we do that from a whole bunch of different sides, then we get sort of a transition. And sort of the more blocks we add to that, the more effective it'll be, But almost like the grass is sort of reaching out into the desert. So that might be one way that we can kind of help with that transition. Now, my goal for the beginning of this episode, now that I've kind of shown you guys that, is I want to finish doing this in this area. So for example, that includes, like, you'll notice my house sits on top of mesa and it's covered in dirt, but this is not covered in dirt up here. Now that might be a little bit more intrusive into what Lurgan's doing, but I don't know if he has any plans up there or not. And I honestly don't think that he would mind too much, but that's something I'm gonna do as well. And he can always take it down if he wants to, but I'm gonna throw some dirt on there. May or may not plant trees, I don't know, but just to make it consistent with my hilltop, right? So that way it's, the more consistent it is, the more believable I think the area will be. And then we're gonna come through here and do the same thing we did over there, but on here. I'm just gonna put down a whole bunch of grass and bone meal and trees and bushes and things like that. So that way, now we'll be able to get a blocked view of the desert even when we're over here and looking out that way, and I think that'll be really good too. Anyway, I'm gonna get to work on that, and then I will see you in a little bit. All right, sun is starting to set here in Red Star, so we're gonna try and make this quick, but as you can see, originally we had it out to, what, maybe about here? And none of this up here, so now we've got all of this area up here done. I also did, off camera, I did the top of Lurgan's base area, so you can kind of see how that turned out. I tried to make it pretty similar to my mountaintop area as well, but you can notice even up here, I did the grass up here, so it's that same kind of thing, you know, and now we've got on the hilltops as well, which I think is pretty cool. We've got that going. And I wasn't originally planning on doing this. I mean, I talked about doing it, but I wasn't going to this episode. I went ahead and extended the grass all the way out into this desert area. I haven't done the sort of grass gradient transition that I talked about, but I'll tell you what, let me go sleep, and then we're going to walk in from the entrance of, from the walled city into the slums and see how it looks from there. All right, as we're walking up here, I almost forgot to show you something else I did off camera. In Hodag's most recent video, he went through and he added stone. He basically finished off the outer road. So we have these four roads that sort of turn the walled city into quadrants, and we were planning these roads over here, and BC had started them. Well, Hodag went through and he laid out stone all the way around the walled city in a perfect circle. I was inspired by that, so I came through and I just textured it up, similar to the way that the rest of the road looks. I'm not going to walk down that whole thing, but it goes all the way down to the next gate over there behind the pagoda. So, anyway, yeah, just cool, man. Like, that's what it's all about, is we're working together as a team to make this place something really unique and special. So, anyway, it was just something I did off camera. I thought I'd show you really quick. But now, as we walk into Red Star, oh yeah, I'm getting some much better feels now. Granted, you can still see the desert through the trees over there. The trees aren't dense enough. Like, if I planted some more here, 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 maybe over here, that kind of thing, it would be a little more dense and you wouldn't be able to see the desert. But I guess I'm not too worried about blocking the desert entirely. Maybe that's good enough. I don't know. Let me know in the comments. We could extend the grass. It's just, once we do, we're getting into a build that AFK Falcon is working on. I don't want to interfere with that. But I think it's cool now. Not only are there trees up there, but now there are some trees over there, and it's giving some depth further up too. Like, the more you look up, the more depth you're getting up there as well. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, I like it. So anyway, now we're going to get back to the skyscraper, my friends. And I think today, oh, come on, let's go. Oh, no, no, no. There we go. I think today we're going to, yeah, I just want to take one more look at all the progress we made here. Today we're going to try and finish the exterior of the skyscraper. So we got the structure done, and I'm going to do the flooring on the inside. I'm going to do that totally off camera. I might give you an update when it's completely done. But there are a couple of things to the outside of the skyscraper that I'd like to try and do. I'm going to be doing them off camera as well, so I want to explain what they are real quick. One is, I'm going to experiment with glass panes along the first tier of the skyscraper here. Now, I tried black glass panes in my creative world. Oh, wait, is Three Ravens here? Oh, hey, what's up, dude? So, I tried black glass panes in my creative world, and I didn't like how that looked. And BC said, you know what, try some white glass panes or some light gray, and you'll get the lines just from the shadow of those as well, and they'll blend in better. So I think we're going to try that. We'll see if it works. The other thing we got to do is we've got to get a foundation around the base of the skyscraper. So it's going to involve putting in a whole lot of stone probably. I'll probably come up with some sort of like design, I guess, for the foundation. So it won't be strictly stone. You know, it'll be probably some sort of checker pattern or something like that. We've got to get some trees and some basic landscaping around the outside of this thing. But it's going to be interesting because I can't do modern landscaping like I did last season. We don't want it to appear too modern, so it's got to be like some kind of steampunk friendly. It doesn't have to be steampunk trees, but that's tough to do, but at least friendly, you know, so I can't be like modern trees, right? So anyway, friends, I'm going to get to work on that, and then I'll show you what I've got once it's done. So I was just thinking that this thing is going to need a really nice lobby design. Now, I've been over to the museum. I'm not going to show it off in this episode, but the museum, the inside of it looks really, really nice. And what Dragon Tech did before he left the server is he contracted SilverKos to handle the interior design for him. So I think that's what we're going to do too. Let me fly on over. SilverKos has a interior design consultancy shop over here in the slums. And so we're going to head over here and we're going to put in a contract basically for his services. Ooh, I can't see shaders. Okay, it's starting to get really dark. Let's see if we can get in here before I can't see anything. Here's the shop right here. There's a little bit of light inside. That's good. Okay, so there he is. He's just logging off the server here. Read me. All right, let's read you. Welcome to the Decorating Consultancy by SilverKos. I offer my decorating skills to spice up your build indoors or outdoors or both. If I use my own supplies to decorate, the price goes up. Hashtag sellout. Honestly, the price is whatever you want to give me, no worries. We can also record the decorating process, or I can do that off camera for you, which is what I'm going to ask him to do. Hopefully we can do a segment where he can give me the grand tour though. Make sure to check upstairs for essential decorating things such as the one and only decorator starter kit and the dirt cheap organic stone. I have a feeling that we're going to be in competition someday because I want to make a landscaping consultancy. So anyway, fill out the form. Okay, so name, project. I tell you what, guys. Yeah, and we've got some other people that have hired him out. So what I'm going to do is, off camera, I'm going to fill out this form. And then, yeah, and then we'll come back and check it out. Okay, so I've got my order all typed up here. There we go. So let's flip over to page 8. And here we go. Name, Coop Dizzle. Project, hotel lobby. Size, medium, large. I wasn't too sure. Supplies. I basically listed supplies for the skyscrapers on the quartz. I just mostly stairs and slabs, but mostly bone and iron would be good to separate the rooms out probably. Let's see. Spruce, which I can provide the spruce wood. Terracotta blocks if available, or carpet for rugs. I don't know when he's going to get to this project and if the new update will be released, so either one of those will work for the rugs. Terracotta would be cool though, because I think you could get some geometric patterns that would look a little more art deco. But anyway, other wood types for furniture and just whatever else. I'm sure he'll think of tons of stuff. Price, 10 diamond blocks. Now, Dragon Tech paid SilverKos 5 shulker boxes to do the interior of the museum, which turned out amazing. And the hotel lobby is not quite as big as the museum, but I want him to really be able to do something special. So I'm going to go ahead and overpay him the 10 diamond blocks to do that. Notes. I would like to see, I just added some additional notes so he has an idea of what I want. I would like to see multiple rooms to include a check-in area with a waiting queue, because this is going to be a hotel. A lounge / bar lounge area. Okay, a little repetitive, but that's fine. A tailor just for show, a Red Star gift shop just for show, and perhaps restrooms if you can squeeze them in, an elevator facade, I think I spelled that right, and a ceiling design. The elevator thing is pretty important because we are going to need at some point to put an elevator to get to the different floors. So wherever he puts that in, that's where we will put ours in. But yeah, there we go. We've got that all sorted out. Now our next stop is to get back to the hotel and see if we can add a little more depth and detail to the exterior of the hotel. So I'm going to head that way and sleep real quick so it won't be so dark. All right, well, I'm going to call the exterior completely done. I don't know, maybe we'll add some stuff later, but for now, guys, I think this is looking pretty sweet. So the main things I did here, I talked about adding glass panes down here at the bottom. I ended up deciding against that because, honestly, I think it's fine. Even though it's kind of plain down there, I think it's fine because it really sort of separates that area from the rest of the build. I did add some arches here, though. These lines that sort of go all the way up and then arch and go all the way back down. And so there are 3 arches going all the way up, and I did that on all 4 sides. I think that really, really helps to break up the windows because now we have one, and then we have a gap. We have one, a gap, 2 windows, and then the same thing over here. So I think that was really the big piece that this tower needed to really stand out and look really, really cool. So let's have a quick fly around and sort of check this out from some different sides, just so you can kind of get an idea here of how this looks. Another thing too is I kind of want to show this to you without the shaders. You can kind of, if I get real close, whoa, see the glass panes? I should have told you sooner so you'd know to look for it, but here we go. Okay, there you go. You can see it on this side a lot better. There's glass panes. Railroad track, woo-woo! That was a cool server project from this past weekend. But anyway, can you see it better here because we're in the shadow side? I think that's why. But it looks much cooler and it really, really stands out without the shaders too. So let's come down here and check out the landscaping stuff. I really didn't do a whole lot, guys, because I know that we want these buildings to be really close together. So like whatever my neighbor tower is, it may not be more than like 3 blocks separated from this tower. And so, yeah, if I put trees in, then I have to leave several blocks of space in between. And I want my neighbor to basically be able to build like starting right here. You know what I mean? At most. And so, yeah, that's just part of the aesthetic we're going for. We want our buildings to be really kind of scrunched up together. But I did do a little bit of work here, and maybe it's a little bit modern, but you know, you gotta have something. So I included some benches, I included some bushes, and I included some peony bushes as well. And I did that a little bit on this side too, because, you know, I figure if someone builds, they might be able to squeeze something in right here, but I can't imagine we're gonna get a skyscraper right here. More likely we'll get one right along here somewhere. So, or maybe one right behind. So I'm not sure. I just tried to kind of do that sort of forward thinking to the future. It really doesn't leave a whole lot of room for exterior detail, but we do have a foundation in, and I definitely think it looks much better on that than just sitting on grass. So we've got a little bit of a walkway up here. I just put a little bit of depth into it. And let's go inside. SilverKos has already finished up the interior, which you really can't see with shaders on. So I'll tell you what, let's turn shaders off for now and see what this looks like here on the inside. All right, here we go. So now we have this beautiful hotel lobby that SilverKos designed for us. We've got these 4 really huge pillars here. And I think this might end up being where the elevators go in if I decide to do elevators, because right now there's no way up to the 2nd floor, which frankly is fine. I'm totally cool with this just being an aesthetic build, but if we ever do want to purpose it for something, we could do that. Part of me is tempted to come in, although that is kind of a nice texture change, I suppose, with the bottom of the bone block, but part of me wants to go in and put those in sideways. So let me know what you think in the comments. Should I do that? Go in and put those like sideways in there? Or maybe add some court stairs. I still have a little bit of those, I think, to kind of maybe do a little bit of arch work. That might be kind of cool. Add some arches to it. But anyway, so we've got these pillars. They can act as our elevators if we choose to do that. We have a lounge area right here with some really nice sort of lounge couch designs. He went for a very modern interior. Like, I noticed there's a TV, a big screen TV here, which I think is kind of funny since we're in a steampunk world. I don't know that you would have TVs in steampunk, but who knows, maybe. We have the tailor right over here, and I love how he did this. Check this out. You've got your spot where you set up here, and you can look. You've got a mirror. How cool is that, dude, for a mirror? Really cool. And, you know, I could get, like, some different armor and stuff and put that on here, so it could be, like, the suit thing. That could be really cool. We have some more lounge chairs. And then we have a little bar area over here so you can get your drinks and your club sodas and whatnot. So very, very cool. Oh yeah, and he's got a gift shop. The Red Star postcards and Red Star souvenirs. And check this out. He's even got stuff in here. So we've got some redstone for the souvenirs and we have paper for the cards. Really, really cool. It's hard to see with my resource pack, but he's got these clear glass panes holding up the redstone. So it kind of looks floating in my resource pack, but I'm pretty sure in vanilla, the regular default pack, it looks a lot nicer. And of course, you've got the reception desk right here, which apparently has some laptops and a little receptionist guy if we want to dress one up right there. So, oh, and the ceiling design. Did you see the ceiling design? Really, really cool. I really like that. Just a really modern, cool pattern. I really dig it. So SilverKos, great job, buddy. Let's head out here real quick. I want you to see what those glass panes look like in the, well, I guess without shaders. I can't say in the vanilla pack, but yeah, see how much that stands out now? I just think that turned out really, really cool. By the way, I want to say one other thing before we go today. I'm sorry if this clip is a bit talky, but part of the reason it's taken so long for this video to come out, I want to let you guys know it's for a couple of reasons, fam. The first reason is that my job, this is the busiest time of year, so it's really hard for me to do videos, especially Minecraft videos. So being able to do the XCOM series has really helped me to get content out. And by the way, the people that have watched the XCOM series are really digging it. So if you haven't checked it out yet, please go check that out. The other thing though is that I died at least once, but maybe twice while AFKing at Technogizmo Skelly Farm for bone blocks. And I had actually recorded some stuff kind of showing that, but for some reason I screwed that up. So anyway, thanks to Cortez Arino and thanks to Crafting Mantis, they helped me get set up with a brand new set of amazing gear. So we've got Poseidon's Crown back, which is the same as it used to be. Who was it? Howitzer and Hodag found some of my gear, so that was cool. So I got my cape back, elytra, but I made some new pants, and these diamond boots, holy cow, are totally decked out. Crafty Manus basically gave the boots to me just like that. And then we've got the chest plate. Everything's just decked out. Look at this sword. Where's my money? So if someone owes me money, you know, I can go up, where's my money, and just start beating him with the sword. But looting 3, sweeping edge 3. I've never had a sweeping edge 3 sword before. This is totally amazing. And it's got all of the stuff on there. It's just amazing. I got my bow back, which was cool. I've got the Get Rich or Die Trying back. And let's see, I don't really have a good diamond shovel yet, but the axe is pretty good. It's a Silk Touch Efficiency 5 axe. So anyway, thankfully, thanks to those guys, I got some really good gear back and everything is good. And you know, as far as Minecraft videos goes, like I said, it's probably going to be a while again before I get a Let's Play out. So please be patient with me. Again, it's just the busiest time of the year, but I am trying with the XCOM videos. And I think the next Minecraft video as well, guys, might be a Sanctuary episode. I'm really close to having that project done, and I feel like it's time. I feel like even if I have to wait 2 or 3 weeks to get the video out, we're going to do a Sanctuary episode and get that series back off the ground again. So hopefully you're excited for that. And hey, guys, thank you so much for hanging out with me today. Let me do this. There we go. Thanks so much for hanging out with me today. If you did enjoy the video, please make sure and hit the like button for me. Feel free to share the video, help spread a good word about the series and the channel. And subscribe if you haven't already, join the Coop Dizzle family, and follow along as we continue to ball hard here on the Diamond Society SMP. But until next time, my friends, may be happy, may be well, and take care. I'll see you later.